Greg Kelly here, Bo Deedle here, a former New York City detective and founder of Bo Deedle and Associates. All right, Bo, years ago when you were on the force, were their tickets fixed?
I hate to use the word fixed. Honestly, remember, I came on in 1970. We had a box. There was no computerization. You get a stack of tickets, they'd be in your locker forever. And whenever you use it, I never gave out many tickets. I went right into plain clothes. But with that said, if Greg is my brother here, and all of a sudden he calls me up and he says, hey, Bo, I got a ticket, I'd go into the box. I'd tell the sergeant, I got my brother got a ticket. Take the ticket out of the box. Not looking for a favor, not looking for compensation. It was something, the way of the world. But that was pre-NAP. We went through NAP commission. Things changed.
One second. That was 1970, you said,
yes.
Right? Because 15 years later, I know it's still a long time ago.
Yes.
I was in high school, and I got a driver's license for the first time. And guess what? The message was, you get a ticket, you pay it. And he wasn't the commissioner then.
Well, the point is, like, I think it's at right now, times have changed, and ethics have changed, and this is totally wrong, especially if you're accepting something for doing it. That's total
but
garbage.
But why are there there's a lot of support for these men and women who've turned themselves in, because last night they showed up at court. You see a lot of people outside the courthouse
You saw what this led to. This led to now the whole corruption factor of those other cops getting set up by internal affairs, buying guns, buying untaxed cigarettes. It just goes on and on. The bottom line is, you've got to keep the ethics right in the police department. It's a semi-military thing. You got to keep the ethics right. And with that said, is times have changed from 1970. Now we're in 2011. You want to know something? I'm disgraced that I was a policeman, and watching this on TV, it really hurts me, because there's a lot of guys out there that do their job, and they're being scorned upon by this.
I've been getting tickets since I was a junior in high school. Mm-hmm. I still get them. I still pay them. All right, Bo, what do you think about what's happening in Zuccotti Park?
Well, I think it's time. I love what this. I know Ed Mullins there, the sergeant, the SBA guy. I love this idea, because a lot of these kids do have assets.
What idea?
Well, the idea about they're going to start charging him. They're going to go after him civilly if they assault the sergeant of the police department.
They're putting them on notice.
On notice,
they're
right. Because
we know that they have assets now. They have at least $300,000 in the bank, the OWS people.
You know what? They made this statement. Now it's getting to a point when they threaten a reporter the way they threaten your reporter, grabbing the microphone, lock them up, and you want to know something? I'm outraged that they could do something like that. The police have been really, really good. The police are not their enemy. I think you know who their enemy is? From within themselves. You could see this kid talking. He was like from Mars. He's probably stoned on some kind of drugs.
Keep in mind.
And that's it.
What John said, though. John has been down there for 6 weeks. This is the first time anything like this has happened to him. And he said, he went out of his way to say, this is not his daily experience. Well, it hasn't even been, you know, once every 6 weeks. Well, the first time something like this has happened. He said most people have been very respectful.
It's not the daily experience of cops fixing tickets either. Yeah. So the point is, once you let that happen, all the troublemakers, like I said, when I was down there with Geraldo, all the troublemakers now are going to filter. Free food, free knapsacks, free this, free that.
Free food might be over. We talked about that earlier.
Point is, what leads in, you get the troublemakers that infiltrate the people that are trying to say something good. I think, honestly, if you're breaking the law, and if Zuccotti wants that park cleaned out, the police have to do it, and that's going to be the end.
And they're not asking for that yet. They asked for it, and they rescinded that request. Because we don't want what happened in Oakland or in Atlanta to happen here. People are getting impatient. Guess what? Do they want a riot? Do you remember the last time we tried to kick them out? Remember that? Not kick them out, but clean the park? We didn't even say kick them out. Move over for 4 hours.
Right.
And 10,000 people, yeah.
Well, you don't want to know something? We got one thing on our side. That thermometer's going down and down.
So
and you're
going
to see a little dispersibitation of the tents, because you can't have little campfires. You can't have generators. There's going to be a time when the frost bites upon your little tip of your nose, and they're going to go.
You know what I'm fascinated with? I mean, what are they doing? Showering? Bathrooms?
Well, a lot of them are going. You know what they're saying? A lot of them are going home at night. They keep
the
tent. And they go there. There's, like I said, there's one woman left her four kids hooked up with some guy. It's a love-in. You know, real fast, Greg, I'm going to this Intrepid tonight for the cancer thing over there tonight. They have the fundraiser for the cancer, breast cancer.
Right.
But you know what? One of our friends, J.P. Morgan Chase. I've been around them for a while. They're starting to hire through me veterans. This is a wonderful thing. Veterans giving houses. giving houses to veterans. This is J.P. Morgan Chase.
Giving houses to a veteran?
Giving
I'm
houses
a veteran.
To
Where's my house?
Well, you don't get it.
Why
People
not?
That need it. But
your employee.
You know what's,
I know. What are they
great?
Doing? Tell us about the program.
What they're doing is they started a program hiring the veterans. Now, what we're doing is the branch banks, and they're putting veterans as security guards on the branch banks, giving them the opportunity ahead of regular people that are looking for jobs. And I love it. I love it. You got Frank Bisignano, Guy Chiarello, Jamie Dimon. These guys are great. You knock the banks for a lot of things, but J.P. Morgan is at the forefront of hiring veterans. And I have to give them a pitch because they get beat up all the time for unnecessarily things. This is a good thing.